Hello, in this tutorial we will learn about the new Scriptcase features available in version 9.10 and the query or grid application. One of the new features in version 9.10 is the date comparison, an option that takes the Scriptcase reporting to another level, further strengthening the already existing business intelligence options within the tool. Together with the comparison, we developed some further options. Let's get to know them all in this video. I have it here. So a report, we can see the options added within the query application. We have a breakdown by category and product. So here right away, we have the graph above the summary. So this application is being started by the summary. We have the graph at the top with the category option and breakdown of categories down below. Here we can observe the general and comparative total next to each of the data points. In other words, we have the products of the total electronics. The headphones represent the 340% or 3.40%, and the same thing also for the sum part to the right. We have here the quantity percentage displayed within the sum field, and then also the percentage displayed for the total price sum field. This is now only available in Scriptcase 9.10. So let's see how it works. At the top of the grid application, we have here our group by. We have this group by the quantity sum as well as the total price. For the dynamic search options, we have multiple fields here and we can compare dates. So let's check out last year and compare that with this year and apply. And just like that, we can now view a complete comparison of categories or products or whatever data we store now within the grid application. We can also break this down further and change the group by category, for instance, and change the date to this year. So we have the last 12 months and the 12 months previous, and apply. And again, now we have our comparison as well as the percentage values. So let's have a look at how we create this same grid application, including these new features available in Scriptcase 9.10. Back within our Scriptcase environment, we can start by creating a grid application. Here, I have a table prepared for this called Comparison. This table has been specially prepared as it includes a whole load of data. When creating the grid, I can also choose to create the form and speed up the development process. This will then link the form with the grid application at the same time and allow me to perform edit, insert, and delete functions. I can also choose to run the application after. When doing so, I can choose to make this a default behavior. Let's go ahead and create our new grid. Okay, so now we have a default grid generated within Scriptcase 9.10, and we have all of the default features, columns, sorting, as well as export functionalities all built in to the default application. We can also use search, as well as the form, which was also generated. Now with our grid application ready, we can start to customize it ready for our new business intelligence features. Within our grid application, we can minimize the grid area and start at the group by section. Here on group by, we need to start by creating a static group by. Here, then click new group by. And we can already add a label as well as a name here. So let's add here continents. And the label will be automatically completed from our group name. Now for our group fields, I will choose here continent, category, and product. And then here for our summary totals, I will choose quantity and price unit. Let's go ahead and run the application and see what it looks like now. Now our grid has been grouped into the three selected groups that we have. We have continents as well as the categories. Okay, so let's return back to our grid application and add another group by. This one, I will call this country. And here I will add the country into the group by field and quantity and total price into the summary totals. Let's go ahead and run the grid application again. And now I have a group by button, and I can choose the type of group by that I want to apply. So let's access the grid application again. And this time grid, and then grid modules. Here we will change the initial module to summary. And on the summary tab, here we can change the settings that we have available here for pagination from total to partial and lines per page 10. Let's go ahead and run the grid application again. We now have our summary report of our electronics within Africa and all of the products displayed, as well as the quantity and price of each group. Okay, so let's return back into our grid application and come down here to summary. And at the same time, we can remove the others out of view. Here we can access fields, and the continents group, which we had created, is available here. We can then choose quantity sum. And here we have now the option to display percentage. So I will enable that. And I can also choose where I want that percentage displayed, to the bottom or to the right. Let's also add that for the price unit. And now run the grid application again. And now within our grid application, we can also see the percentage calculations provided for each group. And back within our grid application, let's access now the settings. And here we can change the display total from last page to every page. And also the position of the horizontal total from bottom to top. Let's run that and check it out again. And now we can see a slightly different positioning of our data. And back into the grid application again, and now access charts and settings. Here within the settings at the bottom, we now have the option to display chart above summary. I will check that and again choose run. Now we have our bar chart displayed above our summary data. Now let's return back to the grid application again. And back in the grid application, we can also make adjustments here to the chart width and the chart height that we want to have displayed back here within the summary application, allowing for further adjustments. Now that we have seen how we can enable the chart above the summary, now we can access also the search functionality, advanced search, and settings. And here, if we disable this option, display after filtered, and run the grid application, we will now see the filter for our search within the grid application on run. Now we can further enhance the search functionality of our application, providing more features to this grid application. Back within our grid, we can access again our search and here select fields. Here we have the available fields that are, here we have the fields which are available to us within the grid search. We can go ahead and add more fields, such as the category and product. Let's also remove the grid comparison. Let's also remove sec, the type client, and then we can also adjust the positioning of our search. We can save that. And let's go ahead and run the grid application again. Now when we add filter, we have each of those filters available to us. With these new advanced features, we can very easily improve our Scriptcase applications, especially with these advanced filter options that are included within the grid application and the new comparison features. Let's return back to our grid application and make some further adjustments. So here in grid, we have here our fields, and here we want to maybe also add the order date as a search field. So let's include that there also, save that in our select fields, and now we have that here also available within our search. And here we can change date to date comparison. Scrolling down, we can then enable and disable specific values current year to date, current year, last year, next year, as well as add our own date ranges. There are many values available for you to choose from. Let's go ahead and run our grid application once more. Now our grid application has many options included. All the previous settings that were available before, new filter and customization options, as well as many new features that have been included within Scriptcase 9.10. Now if we want to compare, we only need to choose the order date and insert the time for which we want to compare various dates. And the chart will be presented with relevant data, as well as the comparisons and evaluation and evaluated data. So with these new options added to Scriptcase 9.10, your business intelligence, as well as those that are provided. So these were the new options added here into Scriptcase 9.10 for reports, or essentially the grid application. And those were the new options available within the grid application for Scriptcase 9.10. I hope you like them and that they are useful to you. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.